tried so hard to see it. Took me so long to believe it. But you chose someone like me to carry your victory. Perfection could never earn it. You give what we don't deserve it. You take the broken things, raise them to glory. You are my champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you won. Say, I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in a heavenly place, undefeated with the one who has conquered it.
Everyone comes crashing. yesterday. I was praying for today because it's worship Sunday. It's praise and prayer Sunday, and we're gonna seek God, and we're gonna pray, and we're gonna prophesy, and we're gonna declare what we wanna see happen this year, amen? What's so awesome about prophecy is that all of us are able to do it. I'm not talking about word of wisdom or knowledge. I'm talking about just declaring things that will edify and equip and comfort. So as I was praying, it was so strong in my heart yesterday, so strong that this year there are going to be giants that are going to be coming down. This year, there are giants. You've got to catch this. This is not a small thing. This is a big thing. This is a giant that's been maybe lingering in your area of authority. And I'm going to tell you this year, that giant is going to come down. I'm telling you this year, that wall is going to come down. champion. I love how the Holy Spirit works. You know, when Nash was speaking, from the very start when she said, draw a line, that's taking authority. Drawing a line takes authority. We draw a line and we say, there is no fear here this year. When we say that, we are taking our authority, drawing the line. And then, you know what? We were texting, Nash and I, and I said, I believe that this Sunday is a Sunday of prophetic declarations, that we are going to be taking our authority. That's exactly what she said today as she was praying. That's what the Lord said, to use our authority to declare what we want to happen in the year 2021. And the Lord brought me to a verse in Matthew chapter 16. Matthew 16, verse 16 downwards up to verse 19. Eyes on Jesus, eyes on Jesus. Hallelujah. Simon Peter answered, because Jesus asked, who do you say that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus answered and said to him, blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. Now note this, eyes on Jesus, eyes on Jesus. When we realize who he is, he tells us who we are. When we see who he is, he tells us who we are. When our eyes are on him, he tells us, I want you to see how I see you, and you have authority. And then he says in the next verse, look at this, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Come on now, we're talking about authority. We're talking about declaring things. We're talking about drawing a line. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will already have been bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will already have been loosed in heaven. It's what's already loosed in heaven. That's the King James Version. Because God, I believe, wants us in this year to see him for who he is. You are our champion. And this, he says, who we are. We have the authority. Amen. We can draw the line. We can speak things. So today, as we sing, as we prophesy, as we declare, for those of you online, I want to say this. Don't just sing the songs like Nash was saying. These songs are very prophetic. I am who you say I am. 2021 is the year we're going to be walking in our authority. 2021 is the year where we're going to say to fear, to sickness, to disease, to anxiety, to despair, to uncertainty, nope, nope, I'm drawing the line. You have no place here. You have no place here. And that is what we're going to do with our authority. We are going to declare who we are in Christ. We are going to declare what he says about us as we look to him. Hallelujah. Amen. I am who you say I am.
Amen. 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 I agree. Maybe you're wondering, why is Pastor Giselle wearing mask? Because in the spirit this year, in the spirit, the body of Christ, I believe, need to take their mask off in the spirit and begin to declare things, because it's going to be a different year. Different in many aspects. But we have the advantage. We have the advantage. And ever, you know, it's by the Spirit. Everything, I love the flow, and I love the songs that we're singing. Because a while ago, I was instructing and exhorting what I felt in my spirit about this year for the church. And more of this next week as we talk about Vision Sunday. But something about taking the land. Something about being Joshua's. Something about victory. The Lord has already given us the victory. See, I've already given you the victory. And how do we battle from the position of victory? We don't battle with flesh and blood. We battle in the spirit. Amen. We take what is rightfully ours, purchased by the blood of Jesus at the cross 2,000 years ago, with our words. Because our faith, our heart is connected to our words. We speak, we declare, we utter things, we create atmospheres, we shift atmospheres. In the name of Jesus, it's time. It's time to open up, mask off in the spirit. in the spirit, begin to declare things. Fear, I love it. Fear needs to go. Even right now, at the beginning of the year, fear needs to go. Body of Christ, fear needs to go. In Jesus' name, we draw a bloodline. No more. No more. In Jesus' name, we declare what we want to happen. We declare what we want to see based on what Jesus has done for us at the cross. Come on, in your own way, wherever you are, online, on site, begin to declare what you want to see. Begin to declare what you want to see, who you are. Come on, declare it. I am blessed. I am favored. I am loved. Begin what you want to see. Glory! Speak, hallelujah. Speak the blessings of God. Speak the favor of God. Come on, everybody. Mask off. Mask off in the spirit. Begin to declare things in the spirit for you and your family. Mask off. Declare it. Declare it. Hallelujah. Come on, let's take a few minutes. Just declare it. Just declare it. Thank you, Lord. Joshua chapter 6. Can I have that verse? Joshua's getting ready to see and conquer Jericho. God has already said to Joshua, I've already given you the land. But look what happened before they conquered. This is what we have and who we have. When Joshua was by Jericho, he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, a man standing before him with his drawn sword in his hand. And Joshua went to him and said to him, are you for us or are you for our adversaries? And he said, no, but I am the commander of the army of the Lord. Now have come. And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and worshipped and said to him, what does my Lord say to his servant? And the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, take off your sandals and from your feet, for the place where you are standing is holy. And Joshua did so. In this battle, this year, the Lord is with you. The Lord is in you. And his sword is drawn. That means, my friends, we already have the victory. He is going to fight for you. The battle is the Lord's. You stand in that victory ground because of what the Lord has done for you. Amen. The Lord is with you, and that is why we can take our place. The Lord is with you. The Lord is in you. The Lord is for you. You are blessed by God. Amen. So we start the year knowing that it's not just about positive outlook. No, it is all about who He is in our lives. It's all about we are in Christ. And God has already given us the victory. Amen. Can we thank Jesus right now? Just give Him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We take a stand, Lord. We take a stand. Make a stand, Lord. Make a stand, Lord. We receive it by faith. Let's sing that chorus. You are my champion.
You are my champion. Giants hold when you stand undefeated. Every battle you won, I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in the heavenly place, undefeated.
the King of Kings. Bow down to the Lord of Lords. Bow down to Jesus. Bow down to Jesus.